Yes, there are tons of cool things that you can do just using the Instagram app itself. However, there are some third-party apps that have some amazing features and tools that I'm dying to share with you. You can use Instagram's native tools to do some amazing things. We even have a video sharing with you the best Instagram story tips and tricks right up there. But there are still some things that other apps do better. And if you've ever posted a video to Instagram stories that's like 2 minutes long and it just lets you post the first minute and you can't figure out how to get that second minute posted, stick around until the end because I'm gonna be sharing a bonus app with you that's gonna solve this problem for life. All of the links to the apps shared in this video, you can find them below in the description. And just letting you know that we are big fans of these apps and we are not affiliates. So the first thing I'm going to show you is an app called InShot. Now the reason I love InShot is because Instagram doesn't really allow you to edit your videos. You can't shorten them, you can't crop them, you can't split them, you can't add transitions, you can't add music. And all of those things are things that we can do within InShot straight from our phone. So you're gonna download InShot, you're gonna open it up on your phone, and the next thing you're going to do is you're going to press video. It's gonna ask you if you wanna create a new video. That is what we wanna do, so you're gonna tap new. So from here, you're going to select the video that you want to use. In this case, I'm gonna be selecting a variety of random videos. I just want to use this as an example with you guys. You press that little tick box at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, and here we have it. We now have all of our videos together at the very bottom of the screen, as you can see. The first thing that I wanna teach you how to do is how to speed up a specific video. So for example, this is a time-lapse that I took. I'm gonna select it, I'm going to slide to the right, I'm going to select speed, and then I'm going to bring it all the way up to 4 times. And if you press play, you will note that it has now sped everything up and we've created our own time lapse. From there, if you want to shorten the clip, because as you can see, this is still quite long, what we're going to do is we're going to drag and drop the edges to be where we want it to be, right? So you might bring it down to there. Now over here, we might have a video that is duplicated, so we're gonna just delete one of them. We're gonna take the second video there and we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna drag and drop the edges to make it even shorter. And you can do this for all of the different videos that you have so that you can make sure that it is the length that you want it to be. Now, the very bottom right-hand side of the screen, you're going to see something that says total. That is the total length of time that your video is. So right now, our video is 10 seconds. Remember that if you wanna upload it as an Instagram story, it does have to be less than 15 seconds. From there, I'm gonna teach you about transitions. So the way to add a transition is in between the two clips, you're going to see a white circle at the very bottom with a black dash in it. If you tap on that, it's gonna bring up the transition options. Please bear in mind that you aren't going to have access to all of the different transitions unless you are a pro member. So we're just gonna select a basic transition, then you can go ahead and add transitions to all of your clips if you so choose. To add music to this clip, what you're going to do is you're going to move the cursor around to where you want it to begin. So in this case, the beginning of the clip. You're then going to tap the music icon, you're going to tap tracks, and from there it's going to bring up all these different album options. These are all music that you can use. You're going to select an album that you want to choose, and then select a song that you want to choose. The pink button with the cloud on it, with the arrow pointing down, that's how you're going to download the song into the app, and then you're going to press use as soon as it's finished, and as you can see, it has brought the track straight into our editing app. From there, if you tap on volume, it's gonna give you a variety of different volume options. We can change the volume percentage, so I like to bring this down to about 25%, and it also lets you fade in and fade out. From there, you're gonna press the little tick mark, you're gonna press the tick mark again, and now the music has been added to your entire clip. The next thing I wanna show you is filters. So if you tap on filter, you're gonna see that it brings up effect, filter, and adjust. Now I recommend going and playing with all of these, but the one that I really wanna focus on today is effect. So if you tap on effect, it's gonna bring up a variety of different options. Not all of these are available for the free users, but glitch definitely is. So if you press on glitch, it's going to add that glitch effect. And if you wanna see what it looks like, just tap that play button in the center of your screen. You're gonna get a good idea of what that looks like, okay? From there, you're gonna press the tick box if you're happy with it. And now you're gonna see it at the very top of your video. You're gonna grab the edges and you're gonna drag that glitch option all the way until the very end. From there, you're gonna press the little check mark. Ba-dum! and we've now added that effect to our video. The next thing that I want to show you is how to add a sticker to a specific part of your video. Within Instagram stories, it will allow you to add emojis and GIFs. However, the emoji or GIF is going to be there for the entirety of the story. What this app is going to let you do is allow it to enter and then disappear at specific points of the video. First thing you're going to do is you're going to press sticker, and you're going to choose the sticker that you want to use. In this case, I'm going to go with some bunny ears. So we're going to tap on the bunny ears, and as you can see, that has immediately added the bunny ears to our video. So unlike Instagram, this app does not have the feature to pinch and zoom. So what you need to do is use the button at the bottom right-hand side of the sticker. It's going to let you make it smaller or bigger, and it's going to let you rotate it. If you want to move it, you're going to tap on the sticker itself and just move it around. Once you've got it in the right place, you're going to press the little tick mark on the right-hand side of the screen. And from there, you're going to drag and drop the edges of the clip to where you want it to start and end within your video. Let's say that we want it to start at the very beginning, and then we want it to end once that transition happens, so we're gonna move it right to about there. And to cut it very precisely, what you wanna do is move your finger slowly so that you're seeing it frame by frame, and you can decide exactly where you want it to end. And there you have it. That's how you add a sticker to appear and disappear whenever you want to do. The next thing I'm gonna teach you is how to remove a part of your video. What you're gonna do is you're going to slide the bottom of the screen and bring the cursor to exactly the point at which you want to cut. We're then going to take our finger and move the cursor to the exact point that we want our video to begin again. Once it's there, we're going to again select that video clip, press split, and it has now created a third video clip. So you're going to select the video in the middle, and you're going to select delete. And voila, you have now removed the middle section of your video that you wanted to remove. At the top right-hand corner of your screen, you're going to press the save icon, which is the rectangle with the arrow pointing upwards. You're going to tap that and press save. Now you want to make sure that you wait until this percentage completely gets to 100% before going to another app or before closing it down. Once it's done, it will be saved straight to your camera roll. What you're going to do is you're then going to open up Instagram, and you are going to swipe from the left to the right, and then you're going to swipe up. Ta-da! It's going to bring up your camera roll. You're going to see that video that you just created, that 9-second video. You're going to select it. And there you go. That's how you add it to your Instagram stories. And if you're wondering how to use this app to change the aspect ratio of your video, all you have to do is press the canvas icon, the bottom left, and then you have all of these different options. You've got a square 1x1 option, 4x5 option, but the one that we want to use for Instagram stories is 9x16. It also gives you the option to zoom in and out. As you can see, if I zoom in by just pinching my fingers, that's going to give you a different blurry background. And if you want to change that background, you can actually just tap background, and it's going to give you a variety of different options, everything from different colors to different gradients to different patterns. So you can definitely have some fun with that, but the one that I like to use the most is the blurry background. Once you've decided what ratio you want to use and what background you want to use, just press the tick box and you will be good to go. As you know, Instagram stories will only let you upload a video that's up to a minute long. Anything additional to that is not going to be included, and the first minute will be divided into 15-second clips. I'm going to teach you how to edit your longer videos into 1-minute clips to make sure that you can upload them onto Instagram stories. For this, we are going to be using an app called Cut Story. So you're going to download Cut Story, open it, and the next thing you're going to do is you're going to tap on video. That is going to allow you to search for the video that you want to import. In this case, mine is one of the ocean. It's 1 minute and 38 seconds long. What we're gonna do is once you've imported your video into the app, you're going to press the icon at the bottom right-hand corner of the app. That's a little arrow pointing down into a rectangle. From there, you're going to select the 1 minute option. So once you press the minute option, you're going to let it do its thing. Sometimes this can take some time because it is processing, so you're just gonna put it aside while you wait. Do not open up any other apps. You need to give it the time to process and cut down your video. Both videos have been done and processed and saved straight to your camera rolls. You can now open up Instagram stories, and you're going to swipe straight to your camera, and it's going to show you both of the videos that you just added. So from there, you're just going to select the video that you want to upload. You're going to press next. You're going to press add to story, and you're going to do that for the second video as well. And that is a way that you can upload a video that's longer than 1 minute long to your stories. Now, bearing in mind that this is not something you want to rely on a regular long-term basis, it's really just if you have a video that you want to upload for some particular reason, but normally you do want to make sure that you are using stories within the 15-second format and that you're not just uploading one long video for people to watch. But hopefully this will help for the off times that you do. Now you might be asking yourself, how do I create Instagram stories that are engaging and on brand? Don't worry, I've got you covered. In this video right here, I'm gonna be walking you through how to create amazing Instagram stories just using the app itself. And if you want to learn how to master Instagram for your business, then you have to check out Social Media Examiner's playlist over here. I hope to see you there.